In this video, we will cover creating and managing guidance lines, as well as using the group manager in the InCommand displays. Knowing how to create and manage guidance lines in the display allows you to efficiently get started in the field and manage lines for future use. When you first load the run screen on an InCommand display, you will be prompted with the new guidance pattern screen. If you have previously created a guidance line, that can be loaded by tapping the load pattern in the bottom left. To create a new guidance line, you'll first select the pattern type. You can choose between four different pattern types: straight, which allows you to mark an A point and then either enter a heading, base it on the current heading, or mark a B point. Smart path, which is a pattern designed to give guidance from any previously driven paths. This is used in irregular shaped or terraced fields where not all passes run parallel to previous passes. It can be used to create straight AB lines within the smart path pattern and cycle between straight AB and smart path at any time. Smart path patterns are not able to be saved for future use. Identical curve, which allows you to follow gentle contours in the field and is based on original curve driven. Pivot, which is used in fields with a center pivot and allows you to drive concentric circles around the center pivot. For this example, we'll tap on the straight pattern. On the right, under Pattern Options, you can adjust the guidance width if you'd like it to be something different than your implement width. For example, if you wanted to intentionally overlap your tillage implement, you could set the guidance width a little narrower. If you're doing controlled traffic or use tram lines, those can be enabled by checking the Enable Tram Lines checkbox. If using Access Path, those can be enabled and configured by checking the Enable Access Paths checkbox. For this tutorial, we'll leave them both unchecked and tap the green check. Using straight lines, you can now create one by setting an A and B point, using the current heading, and manually entering a heading value. We'll tap to use the current heading button. This will set an A point at our current location and draw a line with our current heading of 90 degrees. By default, the guidance lines are automatically saved. Once the guidance line is created, there are some new options on our guidance tab in the upper left. Reset will unload the guidance line and allow us to create or load a different guidance line. Using the AB or Smart Path toggle button, you can toggle between straight or curved lines and Smart Path. If there are multiple lines that an operator would like to use at the same time, for example, a line along the south fence and the west fence, we can create a pattern group to easily switch between the lines. To begin creating a group, tap the AB manager. Here we have our line we just created and can see a preview on the right. Tap the line and we can rename it by tapping the keyboard. Additional lines can be added to the group by creating a new line or loading an existing. We'll create a second line to add to the group by tapping the green plus. When adding additional lines to the group, only straight, pivot, and identical curves can be added. Tap the green check. Once we're lined up with the west fence, we'll tap the Use Our Current Heading of 0 degrees. Once you have all the lines you'd like included in the group, tap the wrench on the Guidance tab. On the left, tap Save Group. You can edit the name of the group by tapping the keyboard icon. Tap the green check to save the group. When we come back to the field for our next operation, we can reload previously created lines or groups. To load a previously created line or group, tap Load Pattern. Here, we can see our individual lines or our group as noted by the icon on the left. When we select the group, we can see on the right a preview of all the patterns. Note the location of the green and red dots. They are your A and B points. Tap the green check. When loading guidance lines, we can change the guidance width if needed, and we can apply a shift if needed, such as coming back with a different implement or if we want to be offset of a previous pass. The direction of the shift is going to be in reference to the A and B points. Tap the green check. All the lines are now loaded in the group. Tapping the cycle forward and cycle backward buttons will cycle between all the guidance lines in the group. As you cycle through the line name will show up on the bottom of the screen. Now you will be able to create and manage individual guidance lines, as well as use the guidance line group managers in the InCommand displays. If you would like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.